If you've been running Google Ads for any period of time, then you'll notice this little limited by budget warning appearing on your dashboard. And have you also noticed that when you increase your budget, you still see the ads limited by budget warning on your dashboard? So is this just Google trying to upsell you? What is gonna happen if you don't increase your budget at all? And will you really get more conversions if you increase it to the amount they say that you have to increase it to? Well, I'm gonna clear the confusion and I'm gonna answer all of those questions in this video. Now, if you're new here, welcome. Welcome to Neptune Design. And what we do in this channel is we teach you everything you need to know about Google Ads and how to run your ads the right way. So if that's something that you're interested in, make sure you hit that subscribe button and also hit that bell button so that you can get notified every time I drop new tutorials just like this one, which we do about once a week. Every week or so. So make sure you hit subscribe and let's get into the video. Now, over the past 6 years, everyone I've taught on Google Ads has always asked me, Devin, why does this limited by budget thing keep on showing up in my dashboard? So I finally decided today after 6 years just to make a video about it. And I'm gonna tell you exactly why that is. All right, so I want you to imagine that you're a bike shop owner in New York City and you've got the search ad and you're targeting everyone in New York City and you're targeting them for the keywords bike shop near me. Now, you've got a very, very tiny marketing budget of only $10 per day. And you know that with $10 a day, you're only gonna get a certain amount of clicks on your ads before your budget is finished. But here's the problem. New York City is a huge place and people are searching for your keyword more often than you are showing up. In fact, in New York City, there's about 49,500 searches for bike shop near me every single month. So although you're only showing up for a few searches and getting a few clicks on your ads, when your budget is finished, your competitors are still showing up. They're still showing up and people don't stop searching because your budget is finished. Those people are still searching during the day, during the night, the next day. So when your budget is finished and more people are still searching for those keywords, Google is just telling you, hey man, your ads are definitely limited by budget. And they're right, because people are still searching for your ads, for your product, for your service, but you're not showing up because your budget is depleted. It's finished. It's gone. So in this case, your ads are definitely limited by budget. Now, the second question I get is Google trying to upsell you? Have you ever had this situation whereby you've got a small budget, you increase it, you listen to the recommendation, and your ads are still losing money, you're not getting conversions, and then you increase it even more and your ads are still losing money and you're still not getting conversions, and all the while you're just burning through money? Now, if that's ever happened to you, then yes, Google is definitely, without a doubt, 100% trying to upsell you. And the reason why I know this is a lot of business owners think that if they can get clicks through to their account, if they can get enough clicks, they can get conversions. You know, it's a numbers game. Try and get as many clicks as possible and then you'll start getting conversions. But sometimes your offer just doesn't work. Sometimes your ad just doesn't work. Sometimes people come to your page expecting something and they just not getting what they're expecting. And that is the situation. No matter how much money you spend and no matter how much traffic you get through, a small percentage might convert, but the large majority, the majority that you're paying for, is just not going to convert. And even look at the way that Google Ads words its recommendation. They always tell you that if you spend $100 or $200 more, you might or you may get more conversions. They never say you definitely will based on our analytical data. They say you might get more conversions. If I tell you, hey, I'm coming to your house on Tuesday, that's a definite. If I say, hey, I may come to your house on Tuesday, I might come to your house on Tuesday, that is a whole different kettle of fish. So I want you to be sure that your ads are actually making you money and getting you conversions. Now, we'll get into that later in on the video, but don't just accept recommendations from Google Ads blindly, because yes, they will definitely upsell you. And remember, they make the suggestion, but you're the one ultimately who's taking the risk by spending money and spending more money on your ads. Now, if you've gotten any value out of this video so far, let me know below in the comments section. And now let's solve this problem. All right, so in what case do we actually increase our budget? When is a good time for us to increase our budget? And how do we actually know when we can start scaling up our budget? Okay, so there are three things that I want you to look at. The first one is pretty obvious, but I want you to go to your dashboard and I want you to go and look for a metric that says cost per conversion. So basically, if you were selling a $500 product and your marketing, your ads, spending all of these ads was costing you $1,000 just to get a $500 conversion, then of course you'd be crazy to scale your campaign. So don't scale your campaign at all. However, if you're seeing that your cost per conversion is effective, so for example, you've got a $500 product, but it's only costing you $50, then of course you can scale your campaign because you're gonna get more conversions for $50. So doesn't matter how much you increase your budget by, you still be cost effective. However, if you're losing money, you're burning through money, then don't scale at all because it's just going to be a losing formula. It's not like all of a sudden you're going to become profitable. I haven't seen it happen in my 6 years of experience with Google Ads. Usually it's because there's a big problem either with how much you're paying for clicks or with your entire funnel or your entire messaging. It could be a lot, but don't scale. You're just going to burn through money. Second thing I want you to look at before you increase your budget is, are you actually getting enough clicks to your offer in the first place to see if it's a good or a bad offer? Now, if you're brand new to Google Ads, you might think that if you get 3 or 4 clicks and no one converts, no one buys, oh no, this campaign is bad, this product is bad, I should probably do something else. It definitely doesn't work that way. In fact, on average, it takes about 100 clicks to get 3 or 4 conversions on your ad. So if you're just getting a single click every single day, you're never gonna know if your product is good or bad. You're never gonna know if your service is good or bad. What I usually advise my clients to do is get about 300 to 400 clicks before they decide if a product is good or bad or before they start drawing any conclusions. And yes, in this case, you would need to increase your daily budget so you can start getting more clicks through so you can figure out if this is a good product or if this is a good service. Now, if you continue just getting 1 click a day or 2 clicks per day, it's gonna take you about 100 days or 200 days to even see if your product is working out. So in that case, yes, Definitely increase your budget, get more clicks in, and figure out whether your product or service works or whether you need to tweak something. So the last thing I want to say is some industries have extremely expensive clicks. Like if you go into the financial services sector and your daily budget is like $10 a day or $20 a day, it's not going to last long. And those clicks are extremely expensive. In fact, I've seen some clicks that are over $150 just for one click on your ads. Now, if this is the case, what I suggest you do is go back and do your keyword research properly. Now, I've got a whole video over here where I show you how to find cheap, effective, high converting keywords. Make sure you give that a look and make sure you redo your keyword research because your keywords are just way too expensive for your budget. And that also happens often. Now, if you're trying to make Google Ads work on a tiny budget, I want you to check out my Ultimate Google Ads Blueprint for Business Owners. It's about 13 hours of video showing you how to do every single trick I know to get the best out of your budget with Google Ads. My favorite part is the Never Trust Google part, where we basically talk about every bad thing and every upsell in the Google Ads platform and how Google Ads actually gets you to choose the wrong setting. So it's really cool. There's personal coaching for me included in the course as well, and it gets updated regularly with new content. So you don't have to worry about buying a course and then it gets old and then you're like, why did I pay for this course? Because everything's changed in Google Ads. It's really cool. So if you're interested in that, check it out at the link in the description below as well. That's the Ultimate Google Ads Blueprint from me and Neptune Design, and I'm excited to see you there if you decide to sign up. Lastly, thank you so much for watching this video. I've been wanting to do a video like this for a long time now, so I really appreciate you watching it. If you want something else to watch, you can check out my Google Ads Beginner playlist over here, and I will see you next time. Please comment below if you enjoyed it, like, subscribe, share with a friend. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Peace.